This is the third video by Prevent for Work, inspired by the article What Does Best Practice for Musculoskeletal Pain Look Like? By Evan Lin and colleagues. The general recommendations for an active lifestyle also extend to people with musculoskeletal pain. Therefore, physical activity does not have to provide pain relief for all patients in order to be a relevant intervention. Rather, since physical activity is beneficial for general health and well-being, the recommendation is that patients should receive management that addresses physical activity and/or exercise. Importantly, physical activity does not necessarily mean sweating in a gym. It can be a daily walk or anything else that increases heart rate, stimulates muscles, and is meaningful to the patient. Along the same lines, professionals should facilitate continuation or resumption of work in most cases. For some patients who experience pain, it can be relevant to have a short period of time off work, but in general, it is safe to work although it can be painful. It seems that being able to continue working despite pain reduces the risk of negative social and economic side effects that are usually associated with prolonged sick leave or unemployment. Successful return to work should be considered a team effort, and it can be facilitated by adjustments in the daily workload or routines, or even to start on part-time whenever possible. Another potent recommendation across all guidelines is to provide patients with education about their condition and management options. In essence, this means to give the patient sufficient knowledge about their pain and how they should manage it, so that they are comfortable making decisions about how to self-manage. Traditionally, manual therapy and surgery have played a major role in the management of musculoskeletal pain, but it is now recommended that you apply manual therapy only as an adjunct to other evidence-based treatments. It is also recommended that, unless specifically indicated, for instance in the case of a red flag condition, you should offer evidence-informed non-surgical care prior to surgery. In fact, surgery is not recommended at all for several musculoskeletal conditions, including non-specific shoulder and back pain.